Welcome to HW News. In a major development in Jammu and Kashmir politics, Kashmiri separatist leader Syed Ali Shah Gilani on Monday announced his resignation from the All Parties Hurriyat Conference. In an audio message that was released today, Gilani made the announcement regarding his resignation and added that he is distancing himself from the Hurriyat Conference. He said, "In the view of the present situation, I resigned from All Parties Hurriyat Conference. I have informed all the constituents of the Hurriyats about the decision." Now, Gilani also cited rebellion against his leadership by cadres as one of the reasons for his resignation. Gilani, who was a three-time MLA from Sopore, served as the chairman of All Party Hurriyat Conference, which was a conglomerate of all the separatist parties in Jammu and Kashmir. Now, previously, he was a member of Jamaat-e-Islami in Kashmir, but later on, he founded his own party by the name of Tehreek-e-Hurriyat. Gilani has been accused by the political leadership in Kashmir for the rise of militancy and bloodshed in the region. In his letter, Gilani has accused the Pakistan-based separatist leadership of nepotism and political corruption as well. He also accused the Pakistan-based separatist of misinterpreting his speeches and taking decisions arbitrarily without keeping him in the loop. Syed Ali Shah Gilani, who has mostly been in house arrest since 2010, has also criticized the Modi government's decision on August 5 to scrap Article 370 and 35A, describing the move as a plan to convert Kashmir into another Palestine. Now, he slammed the separatist of his faction for failing to react to the post-5th August scenario. His resignation is another blow to the already weakening Hurriyat Conference. Now, here is what exactly the expert think of his resignation. What will happen after his resignation?
Gilani's utility for Hurriyat was over long back. So, Hurriyat itself was a combination of various organizations. It is a platform for various organizations. And the brain behind Hurriyat was ISI. It was Pakistani establishment which created Hurriyat. And Hurriyat, one of the basic principles of Hurriyat is you should be an Islamic body and you should not believe in any kind of democratic setup. So it is not a political party. It is a platform for all those people who want to work against basically India's interest in India's security. So Gilani was part of a setup which was essentially anti-India, anti-India's interest. So in such a situation, if Gilani decides to quit Hurriyat, there are two reasons. One, Gilani does not find Hurriyat useful anymore. And B, Hurriyat has no future in itself. These are the two very important reasons. Now, why Hurriyat feels that there is no future for them? That is because of the change of status in Jammu and Kashmir. A, it is now a centrally union territory. And B, the very existence of Hurriyat and other people were on the basis of the special status that Jammu and Kashmir enjoyed by virtue of Article 370. Now, after the knocking down of Article 370, there is nothing on which they can function. Now, they cannot go and convince the people of India or the Parliament of India that Article 370 should be restored. It is a dead issue now. So, what is the basis on which the Hurriyat will function? So, Gilani quitting Hurriyat, and as far as political force is concerned, people in Kashmir are not going to recognize another political forum like Hurriyat. Even otherwise, Hurriyat has been written off long back. So, I don't think such Hurriyat or any other organization like Hurriyat has any future in Kashmir. See, the resentment, what he is saying, resentment, he was the unquestioned leader of Hurriyat, even otherwise. So if he says that my own colleagues have gone against, that means his colleagues have gone against his own decision. That means, so he has not been able to lead Hurriyat for whatever it is. No way. It's actually a victory for India. We have always maintained, although former prime ministers continue to talk to Hurriyat, But we have always maintained that we should have no talks with Hurriyat at all.
Well, the weakening of the Hurriyat conference began when it split into two factions, one which was led by Gilani himself under Hurriyat Conference G and another which was led by Mirwais Umar Farooq. Now, though Gilani's faction remained more prominent in the last decade, it has also lost significance in Jammu and Kashmir. What impact will this development have on Kashmir and its internal politics now remains to be seen. Do let us know what you think in the comment box below. For more news and update, you can log on to www.hwnews.in.
हमारे घरों में भी बच्चे होते हैं जो हमसे प्यार दुलार की आस करते हैं।
हमारा भी जीवन साथी है जिसको हमारे ड्यूटी से घर आने का इंतजार होता है।
हमारे घर में भी एक बूढ़ी माँ है जिनके लिए आज भी हम ही आंखों के तारे हैं।
लेकिन हम हमारे घरों में नहीं है, आपकी सुरक्षा में कोई कसर न रहे, इसलिए हम अपने प्रियजनों से दूर है।
हम में से ही कुछ तो अब इतने दूर जा चुके हैं कि वो वापस अपने घरों को लौट भी नहीं पाएंगे।
हमें गर्व है, हमारे कंधों पे मुंबई शहर के नागरिकों की सुरक्षा की जिम्मेदारी है। हमारे जज्बे और बलिदान को व्यर्थ न जाने दे। इस संकट के समय में आप घर पे रहे, सुरक्षित रहे।
Now be the first to know about the latest updates on our new news app. Go on your Android or iOS, search for HW News Network. Download our app, choose the language you prefer to get updates in, and be up to date with the latest news.
If you like this video, please share it and we would love to hear your comments in the comments section down here. Also, please do like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter to get minute-to-minute news updates. For more such shows and videos, well, subscribe to our YouTube channel.